In this video, you'll learn how to train an autoencoder in KNIME and how to evaluate and optimize its performance. Let's get started. An autoencoder is a feed-forward neural network that compresses the input data onto a bottleneck hidden layer and reproduces it on the output layer. Autoencoders can be used, for example, for dimensionality reduction, noise removal, and anomaly detection. This video shows an anomaly detection use case by training an autoencoder to detect abnormal heart rhythms from a patient. The ECG data contains normal and anomalous heartbeats. This time series data has 140 points, where each row represents one heartbeat. The class column indicates whether a heartbeat is normal, class 0, or anomalous, class 1. Have a look at a random instance of normal and anomalous heartbeats to get an idea of how the data looks. After reading in the data, some pre-processing is needed. First, partition the data into training, validation, and test sets. Note that all the anomalous heartbeats are excluded from the training and validation data so that the autoencoder only learns how to reproduce the normal heartbeats. Some of the anomalous heartbeats will be used in the test set for evaluation. After that, normalize the features to the 0 to 1 range. Use the same normalization model to normalize the validation and test data to avoid data leakage. You can also save this model for later deployment applications. As this is a rather easy example, choose a simple initial architecture. Note that layers, activation functions, and the level of compression could be optimized. This architecture compresses the data by a factor of 2. Next, let's move on to network training. In the configuration of the learner node, select the input and target columns and their conversion. The input and target columns are the same by definition. Remember, the task of the autoencoder is to reconstruct the input data. Select mean squared error, or MSE, as the loss function. Finally, select the atom optimizer with default parameters. After training the autoencoder, you can observe the loss for each epoch. After the network is trained, apply it to the test data with the Keras network executor node. Simply configure the input and output setting, and then execute the node. This node produces the reconstructed features. This model is now optimized to recreate normal heartbeats, since only those were included in the training set. The difference between the original features and the reconstruction is called reconstruction error. If you look at an example of a normal heartbeat, you can see that the model appears to be doing a good job in reconstructing it. For arrhythmic heartbeats, on the other hand, the model could do a poor job reconstructing. You can capitalize on that fact and identify anomalies based on larger reconstruction errors. Calculate the reconstruction error as the mean squared error with a small Java snippet. If you have the distribution of reconstruction errors, you can see that the average reconstruction error for normal heartbeats is significantly lower than the average error for anomalous heartbeats. You can now set a baseline threshold for how large an error may be before it is categorized as an anomaly. As a first heuristic, define this threshold as the mean plus one standard deviation of the reconstruction errors of normal heartbeats. You can use some positive examples to further adjust or optimize the threshold. This parameter optimization loop finds the best threshold value with the maximum overall accuracy plus an additional constraint that sensitivity and specificity deviate at most 10% from each other to account for the class imbalance. This restriction can be adapted to the available data and the individual focus to be set. Finally, compare the actual and predicted classes with the scorer node. 100% of the arrhythmic heartbeats were detected. Using the optimized threshold, the model misclassified less of the normal heartbeats. In this case, it's more important to detect all anomalous than normal heartbeats. As the next step, you could optimize your model architecture to try to reach a better performance by adding layers or compressing even further. If the performance is satisfying, save the model for deployment with a Keras Network Writer node.
In this video, you've learned how to train an autoencoder in KNIME and how to evaluate and optimize its performance based on the reconstruction error.